Hello and welcome to the new topic on email. Email is another protocol which is running on the application layer for exchange of information to the electronic means. So we call it as an application that allows users to exchange messages, which we term it as an electronic mail. A simple example which you can understand how the emails are exchanged between two different entities, that is the two different users. So basically a request comes from the user Alice. So the request is being forwarded to the corresponding email server. So the email server is basically a software which tries to transform that particular email to an network understandable format, and that particular server sends to another corresponding email server at the receiving side, and that receiving side email server tries to transform into a corresponding format and forward that request or forward that messages to the recipient. So this simple process involves a lot of information exchange with the help of certain protocols. So the basic protocols in the emails basically are SMTP, that is simple mail transfer protocol. The simple mail transfer protocol server runs on the email servers to transmit the corresponding emails from one end to the other end. Along with the SMTP, there are other two protocols called post office protocol and IMAP protocols, which you'll study in the due course of our study in the other presentations. We'll try to understand here. But before we proceed to the protocols, let us have an understanding about what an email contains. An email is composed of four components. These are the message itself, the message format. It defines how valid email messages are being encoded or been enclosed into the particular format, followed by the protocols that the corresponding email servers needs to follow or needs to observe between the host and the servers for exchange of emails, and the softwares which are available on the client to make the email to be presented in a proper format, and that emails will allow us to create and read the emails in a proper way. And there are certain softwares that allows the servers to efficiently exchange the email messages, such as the SMTP protocol itself. So here, an email basically contains two important parts. One is the header part, followed by the message body. So in the early days of the invention of the email usually contains the ASCII characters. So the ASCII coding was being followed in the olden days, along with the control characters, the carriage return, and the line feeder, which tries to control the flow of characters in the form of lines or in the form of the end delimiters, which allows the email to be properly structured. So the header contains important attributes, the important information from where the email is getting originated and to where the email has to be sent to, followed by the subject and the date and the time in which the email was created. Similar to our post office mail exchanges, this particular set of systems has been generated so that the same set of principles do be followed here in transmitting the emails from one end of the system to another end. So the carriage return or the line feeder control characters help us to differentiate between the header section and the message body. So a line, an empty line with this control characters will delimit the header section with the corresponding message body. So initially, the email messages are composed of the ASCII characters. That was in the earlier days of the email system. And basically that email looks like this as shown in the example, which contains the header as well as the message body. So you might have observed that the email do have a certain header section containing the recipient address, followed by two set of attributes. One is the carbon copy and the blind carbon. The carbon copy will allow us to send multiple sets of emails to the several number of recipients, and the blind carbon copy We'll also send several copies of the messages, but the difference between CC and BCC is that the recipient's addresses are not known. They are kept in blind. Only the address are going to be hidden for the respective users. So the original email messages contains a lot of information here, from where it has been originated, from which particular server, followed by the corresponding domain name, when it was done, and to whom it is to be received, and the receiving email server's addresses, following so forth. So these are all in the set of using the ASCII characters. But as the technology has improved, so people not only trying to use simply the ASCII characters, but then other set of encoding techniques to send not only simply the text messages, but if you want to send other different multimedia data along with the emails, then a different set of procedure has been evolved, where the Internet Engineering Task Force has developed a multi-purpose internet mail extensions, which will not disturb the original procedures of sending the data. So this, what is MIME and what is its usefulness and how it is useful, we'll be studying in the next video. Once the MIME extensions have been completed, we'll once again come back to the protocols related to the email and understand how SMTP, the POP and the IMAP are functioning. So they'll help us to exchange the information in the email. So let us see with a one live example what the email contains